Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my UMass Dynasty in NCAA 12. The UMass Minutemen are now 7-3 after beating Akron, and now they take on Bowling Green, who is 5-5 on the season. We had some requests for season stats up to date, so I'm going to bring you those right now by request. Wesley Collins, in the passing game, you look at our running game, Jim Mitchell, 829 yards. 5 touchdowns. I'm surprised he doesn't have more than that, but he does get hurt from time to time. And in the receiving core, Ronnie Parker leads the way with 537 yards and 5 touchdowns. Ronnie Houston has 6 touchdowns there, and not too far down the list there for yardage either, only 10 yards shy. So both Ronnie Parker and Ronnie Houston are doing work in the passing game. So it is time to get this game going here. It's a home game against the Bowling Green Falcons. And we spotlight Thomas Young, as they do often here, one of the leaders of this UMass defense, who, well, let's face it, they're kind of an up-and-down defensive unit. They have their moments that are really good, and they have some moments that are kind of shaky. Let's see which one shows up today. We have the ball first here, and Wes Collins is going to hand off to Jim Mitchell. Now, you may notice something you've requested for a long time. Jim Mitchell's wearing gloves, and he's not the only one. We've got gloves on both Ronnie Parker and Ronnie Houston as well. So those of you that were screaming, put gloves on them, they are now all decked out with their accessories. So you've got that going for us. Let's get this moving here. Draw play to Jim Mitchell. He's going to get popped wearing gloves or not. He goes down hard to the turf. 3rd and 9. Collins to throw. And he's going to try to get it in there to Ronnie Parker, who goes up but cannot make the catch. That's a good defensive play by the Falcons. And they will get the ball via a punt. Johnson's going to hand off to Martin now, and Martin is going to have a nice play to the right-hand side, getting a first down, and Bowling Green establishing their offense early. Johnson is going to throw, and Kobe will make the catch coming back to the ball. He gets first down yardage. 2nd and 3 now. Out of the shotgun, it's going to be a handoff to Martin. He gets loose to the right, and he's got yet another first down. Bowling Green having an impressive first drive on their offense. 2nd and 11. Now we got an option play out of the shotgun. Johnson pitches to Jones behind him. Kind of a tricky, if not dangerous, maneuver. Then they have 3rd and 9 after the result of that play. Johnson has all the kind of time he wants to throw, but he throws errantly out of bounds. UMass holds, and Bowling Green will punt. So Wes Collins, 1st and 10. Throwing to the wrong team there. He thought he had Ronnie Parker. Tried to throw a bullet in there. Well, he was duped by the defensive back, who makes a nice play stepping in front of Ronnie Parker and picking this off. So Bowling Green's defense comes up with the big play right here and turns over UMass's offense. What can they do with the ball? Johnson out of the shotgun. He's going to throw it over the middle to Jackson. That's a connection and a first down. Falcons mean business on this drive. 2nd and 8 now out of the shotgun. Hand off to Martin to the right again. They like this play. UMass reads it well this time. Only gives up a gain of about 3. It's 3rd and 5. We got a lot of no huddle coming from Bowling Green. We got a blitz from the left. Recognizes it just in time. Gets it out to Montgomery, but he will be 1 yard short of a first down. Do we bring on the field goal unit? No, they're going on 4th and 1. Handing off to Martin. He not only gets the first down, he scampers for the touchdown. Oh, a big play for the Falcons right here. Nice blocking and way to read it by Martin. He gets himself in the end zone for a touchdown. A huge 4th and 1 play. Forget kicking a field goal. They punch it in and it's now 7-0. So UMass on their home turf getting Jim Mitchell going. He's not going to go down in that contact. As a matter of fact, he was only shoved out of bounds, or he'd still be running. Mitchell gets this handoff up the middle, 5 yards. So we're getting him started now. 3rd and 4, Wes Collins out to the outside to Howard, the tight end. Makes the catch there in the open, turns up and gets a first down. There we go. That's what we need from the offense here if we're going to get it going and get downfield. So with the replay here, Collins to Howard, and Howard getting first down yardage. Good play for UMass. 1st and 10 now. Collins going to hand off to Jim Mitchell. Gets 4 on the left-hand side. Okay, 2nd and 6 now. Collins going to throw, and it's to Fossell, the other tight end. Makes a nice catch and leans forward for enough for a first down. Nice play. 1st and 10. Hand off to Jim Mitchell to the right. Spin move. Oh, he left him in the dust there. gets a nice gain. It'll be second in inches. Watch the replay here. Jim Mitchell putting on the spin at a nice time and leaving the D-back on the turf. So he gets 9.5 yards, second in inches. It will be Jordan Broadnax into the game. And that quick burst gets him a first down. Second and 10 now, Wes Collins. And he's got time. And he's got Fossell. And he's really close to another first down. It'll be third and inches. The tight end coming across the field provides a big target for Wes Collins. And he hits him right in the numbers. And they are actually right in the hands, actually. And they are in business here with a third and inches inside the 10. Coleman, Dwayne Coleman, the fullback, is good for that first and goal. Second and goal now. Collins looking for the crowd to be quiet. He wants to make sure they have no problems here. Handing off to Mitchell, and he will scoot up the middle. Touchdown, UMass. They are in the end zone to tie the ball game. That's the kind of response you want from your offense. The defense is happy over on the sideline that the game is now tied up. Now they get to go out and do their thing. So 13 plays, 72 yards. It is capped off by a Jim Mitchell touchdown run. And it's now 7-7. Second quarter, 2:12 remaining. Johnson is going to lateral back to Martin across the field. That is sniffed out for a loss of 7 yards. You see Smith comes up to make the play on this. Really no chance of this working at all. UMass had that one figured out well. Third and 15 now. They've got to just keep Martin corralled. And look at that. He almost gets loose. Oh, wow. They stop him 2 yards short. But what an effort by Martin. They have to punt. Collins over the middle to Broadnax. Out of the backfield. Makes a nice catch for 9 yards. It'll be second and one. Well, this is a play that kind of confused me. We're at home, yet Collins is having a problem getting everybody to hear him. Out of the shotgun, he's going to take a sack. Wow, just confusion by the offense all together. And this play just does not materialize as the Minutemen had envisioned it. So Wes Collins eats this one for the sack, not what he wanted to do. As a matter of fact, Wes Collins is shaken up on the play and has to come out of the ballgame. Matthew Quinn in, and he's going to air it out on 3rd and 11. Has a shot here, and Ronnie Houston has his hands on it, but is not able to haul it in. So it'll be 4th down and a kick. Here you see it's a low risk of re-injury, so we're going to put Wes Collins back in the game when we get the ball back. But first, defense has to make some plays here. Only 39 seconds left. Trying to set up a screen. It's Martin. It's working. They got 8 yards there, and it'll be 3rd and 2 now. Johnson is going to throw the shovel pass. Look at that. He gets out of trouble by throwing a shovel pass, and they get a first down. Creative right there by Johnson. He's got not a lot of time left. It's Hail Mary time. Throwing deep, and it's going to be picked off. Nice play there. Reed makes the interception. And that is how the half will end, knotted at 7. The defense avoids any disaster by getting the interception here. So going down the tunnel and into the locker room, tied at 7. Looking for a better offensive output in the second half to take control of this game. But first, they'll have to play defense. Once again, Johnson and the Falcons get the ball first in the second half. That's a first down connection. And maybe this will start as the game started with them getting chunks of yardage. Well, there's Kobe coming back for a pass and making the catch good enough for another first down. 3rd and 10, they find themselves just outside the UMass 40. Johnson has time to load up. Oh my goodness, he's got a man wide open. That's Jackson making the catch. He is in the end zone for a touchdown. Blown coverage here as you see indecisive D-backs. Not sure who they should cover, and they pay for it as the Falcons are in the end zone. Bowling Green strikes on the long pass. Kind of stunned the UMass defense there. They just were out of sync. So it's 14-7 now. Jim Mitchell looking to maybe get another spin move in there, but he says not this time. He gets 6 yards, though. 2nd and 4. Go right back to Mitchell. Not much there. Maybe a yard. 3rd and 3. What will come of this play? We're going to go to Mitchell one more time. We're going to put Coleman in the backfield as the blocking fullback, and he clears the way for a first down. So 2nd and 6 now. Collins to throw. What's he got? He's got Ronnie Houston. Nice catch in traffic there. He got himself open just enough, and Collins found him. So Collins obviously back in the game after being shooken up. He finds Ronnie Parker this time. First down, 1st and goal. It's just inside the 10. Draw play to Mitchell. He gets caught up on the line, and gets just about nothing. Second and goal. This pass to Fozell. Caught and fighting for the end zone. They say touchdown. They give him the touchdown, and UMass has tied the ball game once again. Wow, big play there. It was close at the goal line. Let's watch the replay as Collins gets hit as he throws, but finds Fozell. He fights. I don't know. Did he ever have it? Well, they gave us touchdown, right? Well, not so fast. Booth review. They are going to look even closer at this. We'll probably get another couple angles to look at. That one's kind of at the end of the play. Let's see him stretch out here. I don't know. I don't ever see the ball cross the goal line. I have a feeling this is going to come back against us, and we're going to have to give it another shot to get in there. But let's see the officials review. They come out to tell us what's going on. And indeed, the play is overturned. The ball will be placed just outside the goal line, and we're going to have to punch it in from there. So let's see what we can do now. Thought we had a touchdown. Come out on third and goal. Collins is going to hand off to Jim Mitchell, try to get his second touchdown on the day. No, he's stacked up. It'll be fourth and goal. We just make the decision to go for it. On fourth and goal, can we get it? We're trying to get him to jump off sides, and instead, a lineman jumps off sides. It will be a false start, and now we pretty much have no choice. We're going to have to kick that field goal. An unfortunate turn of events, having a touchdown overturned, then having a penalty, is going to keep us out of the end zone. Instead, we cut the lead to 14-10. Will this be a turning point in the game? I don't know. We'll have to mark it down and see what happens from here on out. There's a minute left in the third quarter. Johnson out of the shotgun. What's he going to do? He's going to throw. Finds Kobe again. Man, they love that comeback route to Kobe. He's making plays. So Johnson is going to maybe scramble. Oh, look at that. We had a man fall down, and all of a sudden, Johnson is running for big yardage upfield. We broke contain, and he's going to go option now. Keeper, he's going to get nothing. Third and 10. Can we hold here? We got to hold him to a field goal. That would be huge. Johnson is looking to throw. What's he got? Oh, no. He's got White, who turns and gets in the end zone. We've given up another touchdown, and this is just not good. This is not good. Fallen further behind now. We can't be trading field goals for touchdowns, but that's exactly what we've done. Bowling Green extending the lead now to 21-10. 11 seconds left in the quarter. Collins finds Parker. Ronnie Parker makes a tough catch and hangs on for the first down. That's how the third quarter will end. Fourth quarter, oh, that could have been picked. And instead, it's going to be fourth down. Down a couple scores, we got to make a decision. We're going to go for it. A bit risky, but we got to take the chance. Collins over the middle. Oh, it's going to be picked off by Lynch. Oh, this makes things even worse. They'll have the ball at the UMass 40. You watch the replay here. Collins trying to make something happen, but that is not what he had in mind. It's intercepted and turned over in UMass territory. So the defense has to come up big here. Second and 15. We got play action. A little dump to the left to Pullman, who is not going to go down. I'm not particularly happy with our first tackle attempts. People are breaking too many tackles against us, and we're going to bring some heat now on second and inches. He's hit. He throws to the end zone. It's picked off by Smith. Believe that's his third interception on the season. And it all happens because of the pressure put in the face of Johnson, the Bowling Green quarterback. Let's see the replay here, as the Falcons fans not so happy about that. He's hit as he throws, and he throws inaccurately and to a UMass defender. So it's first and 10, Collins to throw. He gives it right back. McCoy makes the pickoff, and he's not going down. He's rumbling towards the end zone. Wes Collins, the only one there to stop him from getting in the end zone. Third and goal. We've got a wildcat play with Martin taking the direct snap. Not going to work. We stop it. It's fourth and goal. Please tell me they're not going for it again. No, they will actually kick this time. But look at this. We are almost at the two-minute mark, and it's now 24-10. We have to make something happen in a hurry, and they know we're going to pass. Here they come with the blitz. Wes Collins gets it out to Ronnie Parker. Sheds a tackle. He's going down the field. What can he do one-on-one? Oh, nice cut to the inside. He's in for the touchdown. Oh, if we ever needed a quick score, it was right there, and we got it. Ronnie Parker makes the catch and makes things happen. Watch this. Beats the bump and run coverage, and then he says, get off of me to that defender. And after this, it is just a sick move to the inside to get away to the last chance defender and into the end zone. 24-17, we got a ball game, but we need to stop. Tell me right now, why is Johnson throwing an incomplete? Oh, wow, Bowling Green. I don't know what they're doing on that instance there. It gets 2nd and 10, and we didn't have to take a timeout. Martin gets corralled. It's 3rd and 14. Timeout right there. And now what do they do? Are they going to actually throw again? Yes, Johnson looking to throw. What's he going to do? He's got all day. Is he going to take off and run? No, he's going to throw. He's got a man. One-on-one. The ball is caught, but he's pushed out by the defender. No catch. Oh, my goodness. What a great heads-up play. Knocking the defender out of bounds. I don't know if he gets a foot down either way, but we make sure. And they're going to have to punt. We only wasted one timeout. 1:23 left. Collins. Where's he going to go with the ball? Over the middle. Parker makes the catch. No, he couldn't hang on. It would have been a very tough catch, high degree of difficulty, and you see it is ripped out of there, but it is indeed a catch we needed. So 3rd and 10, Collins looking to throw. No, he's not going to get it off. Oh, you can't take a sack there. 4th and 24. This is huge because by the time everybody gets back, there's less than a minute left. Collins heaving on 4th down. Roddy Parker gets up. He actually had his hands on it but cannot haul it in. Oh, it would have been a miracle catch, but instead it's a turnover. 48 seconds left. Hand off to Martin. Oh my goodness, that's how the game's gone. As you see, he sheds a tackle and goes all the way. We were selling out for an inside run, and that meant it was basically a one-on-one opportunity to the outside. UMass loses that one-on-one, and Martin is in the end zone to seal this game. 32 seconds left. Wes Collins going to load up. Throwing as deep as he can, but it's not deep enough. Joseph picks off the underthrown ball, and that's your ball game. Bowling Green has come in, and they have become bowl eligible themselves, going to 6-5 on the season. An impressive road victory. UMass could just never get it going, whether it was Bowling Green's defense pushing the issue or if it was just UMass not executing. Either way, it's a loss, and so we're now 7-4. As Bowling Green is now 6-5. Your player of the game, Jamel Martin. Obviously, he had a great game, and that's a great pick right there. So UMass goes down in defeat. The stats for the ball game, Wes Collins, 10 of 26, 198 yards, and the one touchdown, but 4 interceptions, 2 sacks. Rough game. Jim Mitchell only had 57 yards, and most of that was in the first half because we fell behind and had to abandon the running game for the most part. You see Dan Fossell has 4 catches for 40. Ronnie Parker, 3 for 115. Houston gets 1 catch for 25. And you see the rest being rounded out. So time to hit the recruiting very quickly before this episode ends. Just going to hit the highlights here of what we are looking at. As, wow, we just need a few more athletes. We need a few more positions being topped off here so we can finish off games like this, come back in situations like this. Bo Nelson could have used a D-tackle, getting some pressure in there today. A run stopper, yep, could have used all that. But he is number one with UMass number one on his list. Justin Townsend, we're fighting a losing battle, but we are fighting tooth and nail to keep him around. Marcus Calhoun, we are number one on his list. Let's hope we can stay there. We really need an athlete who's 81 overall. Greg Vaughn, outside linebacker, still working on him and still in first place. And hopefully going to stay there with that recruiting effort. What do we have next? Steve Matthews. This is a very important piece right here. You've seen the O-line be very inconsistent, giving up a lot of sacks. We really could get this guy in here. Would be just a shot in the arm. We're currently 2nd to Arkansas, so we need to make up that room. Corey Harvey. This is the interesting thing of the week, really. Decided to scout him where I realized we've had him on our board but have not fully scouted him. He's been on the board forever. He's one of those Maryland guys we went around. He just may be a gem. Look at this. Only 54% scouted, I know, but he's taken a huge jump, a +7. Wow, if he's a gem and he's been on our board all this time. So Corey Harvey sitting under our thumb the whole time at a 68, but let's hope he finishes out more close to the 75. That'd be wonderful. That'd be a great move there for us if we can get him. So you see Spicer does commit, so both free safety prospects we have are now committed, although I think they're both about a 68 overall. So next up is a game against Kent State. We could really use a victory in that one, so let's check out the conference standings and see where we're at. We are 3rd place in the MAC East behind Bowling Green, who we just lost to, and Miami University, 6-5, 5-5 overall, but you see where they are at in the division ahead of us. Army, who we placed in the MAC West, is leading over there with a 3-3 in their division. Okay. They're ahead of Northern Illinois. So when we come back, it'll be 6-5 Kent State against 7-4 UMass. Something's got to give in that game. Hopefully the Minutemen will take it. We'll see you next time.